हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ग्रेड 7th लाइंस एंड एंगल्स। बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू लाइंस एंड एंगल्स आर एज फॉलोज। फर्स्ट सम इम्पॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशंस। पॉइंट, इट इज रेफर्ड टू एज अ डॉट। इट हैज नो लेंथ, ब्रेथ और हाइट। इट इज मार्क्ड एज अ डॉट। इट इज नेम्ड विद कैपिटल लेटर्स ए बी सी एक्स वाई जेड etc. Line, it is infinite collection of points. You can notice I have lots of points here which are closed by, right? Still, if we have more, we can have this kind of structure. This is called line AB. As you can see, it does not have any breadth or height. It has only length. It has no endpoints. I have put two arrows here which indicate that it can be extended to both the directions. As it can be extended in both the directions, so it has infinite length. Infinite length means it cannot be measured. It is named as AB. You can write two vertices here, two points to AB, and then put a line like this with the arrows showing both directions. Or with small alphabets as shown below. You can draw a line and name it as small alphabet. Next is line segment. As you can notice here, it is a part of line. It has two endpoints A and B. It cannot be extended in any direction. It has finite length. Finite length, the length which can be measured. It is named as AB with a line segment over it, right? Ray, you can see here it is a part of line again, but it has only one end point and it can be extended in the other direction. It has infinite length. It is named as OP with an arrow over it like this, right? The very good example of ray can be torch light. You have a torch and from as you switch on the button and the bulb glows, the rays of the light, they travel to infinity, right? That is a very good example of ray. From a given point, we can draw infinite number of lines as you can see here. And all the lines which pass through one point, they are called concurrent lines. Now we move on to parallel lines. What are parallel lines? You can see here I have drawn two lines, L and M. The lines which will never meet throughout their length are called parallel lines, as you can see. And the distance between them remains same throughout their length. So these kind of lines are called parallel lines. What are intersecting lines? When two lines meet at a point or they cut each other. Right, they are cutting each other or they are meeting at one point, they are called intersecting lines. Then comes the concept of angle. When two lines, they are meeting each other, they are forming something here, right? This one, this gap, this is known as the angle. Now there are lots of types of angles. Let us see. First one is acute angle. When the degree measure of the angle is less than 90 degree, it is called acute angle. When the degree measure of the angle is greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree, it is called obtuse angle. If the degree measure is 0 degree, it is called zero angle. If degree measure is 180 degree, it is called a straight angle. If degree measure is 90 degree, it is called right angle. Complete angle means 360 degree. Reflex angle, angle whose measure is greater than 180 degree but less than 360 degree is called a reflex angle. Linear pair, two adjacent angles whose sum is 180 degree, they form a linear pair. You can see an example here. I have drawn one ray here also. You are having angle 1 and 2 here, right? Sum of these two angles is 180 degree. Therefore, we say they are forming a linear pair. Now, if we have a, what is a transversal? If you have two lines and there is one line which is cutting them at two distinct points, this is known as the transversal. If you have two parallel lines and a transversal over it, you will have an appearance like this somewhat, right? Somewhat this way, this appearance would be there. L and M are parallel, T is the transversal, and I notice that there are 8 angles formed here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Now, mathematicians have classified them very beautifully into various types of angles. How? Let's see. These two angles you will see here, complementary angle, there are few more types of angles, we will discuss them later. First, let us discuss corresponding angles. Now, I hope you are able to see. Yes, you will be able to see the whole thing very nicely. Great. Now, let us keep on watching and learning. Corresponding angles. What are corresponding angles? Here, angle 1 and angle 6. Angle 1 and angle 6. They are called corresponding angles. Similar positioning is there for 2 and 5 also. So, we have lots of pairs of corresponding angles. Let's see. Angle 2 and angle 5. Angle 3 and angle 8. Angle 4 and angle 7. So many corresponding angles are formed on two parallel lines and a transversal. What is the property of corresponding angles? That they all are equal. That is, angle 1 is equal to angle 6. Angle 2 is equal to angle 5. Means if this angle is 105 degree, angle 5 will also be 105 degree. Angle 3 is equal to angle 8. Suppose this is 60 degree. This is also going to be 60 degree then. Okay. Angle 4 is equal to angle 7. Next is alternate interior angles. What are alternate interior angles? When you get a structure of kind of Z formed here. Here you can see they are forming a Z-like structure. So these two angles 3 and 6, they are alternate interior angles. Similarly on this side you see 4 and 5, they are alternate interior angles. The property is again the same. That is, they are also equal. Alternate interior angles are equal. Means angle 3 is equal to angle 6. Angle 4 is equal to angle 5. Suppose angle 4 is 120 degree. Then angle 5 will also be 120 degree. Now, if there are alternate interior angles, then there must be some alternate exterior angles also. Yes. Which are those? They are angle 2 and angle 7. Angle 2 and angle 7. Similarly, we have here angle 1 and angle 8, right? What is their property? The property is that they are also equal. That is, angle 2 is equal to angle 7 and angle 1 is equal to angle 8. So, what we have got now, that corresponding angles, they are also equal. Alternate interior angles are equal, as well as alternate exterior angles are also equal. Now, there is one more type of angle formed over here, that is co-interior angles. Co-interior angles are the angles which are formed on the same side of the transversal, like 4 and 6, 3 and 5. What is the property of this? Their property is that they are supplementary. Supplementary means their sum is 180. That means angle 4 plus angle 6 is equal to 180 degree. And angle 3 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degree. Now, there are few more types of angles in general that we find. That is, complementary angles. You must have heard the name complementary angles. They are complementing each other. Right? Their property is that the two angles whose sum is 90 degree are called complementary angles. Example, 60 and 30 degree, 10 degree and 80 degree, 0 degree and 90 degree, 45 degree and 45 degree. Both of them, they are complement of each other. How, what do we say? We say 60 is a complement of 30 because when we add 60 to 30, it makes it 90.